Okay, here we have an email. Picture of my Cessna home cockpit. My sim is a fully enclosed 1984 Cessna 172P. Oh my goodness. Yeah, hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Another Swiss 001 video, and welcome back to an interesting video indeed. A few days ago, I actually told you guys to send me in your cockpits, your home cockpits, your flight simulator setups, right? And you guys sent me your flight simulator setups indeed to my email, and we have, this is already the winner. Jesus Christ. This is way better than any setup I've ever had. I mean, I've already showed you my flight simulation / desk setup. I mean, there's really not much to it. It's just really a pretty long desk with a computer and a joystick on it. I mean, this is literally all I use right now. But genuinely, I have such a weak setup compared to you. I mean, yeah, look at this. Damn, this is really cool though. Even though this is very much DIY, right? With this yoke here, this is probably all pretty much self-built. That is like genuinely awesome, especially here, the instruments. That's pretty hard to build, isn't it? You know, especially now it's running Microsoft Flight Simulator 2020, which is making the outside view look beautiful, doesn't it? Yeah, that's really nice there. And then we have some setups like this, which is like, I mean, that's not a large desk there, of course. Yeah, just say that. And Lodovico made the best out of it. I mean, we do have the SciTech yoke, which is a yoke that I don't really recommend anymore, especially if you, you know, have some money to spend. Just get the honeycomb yoke. This is just a general suggestion, no advertisement. But that's actually a proper setup as well. I mean, this is gonna get a lot worse in this video. Let me just tell that. For example, here you have someone from Costa Rica, IB6314. I love, you know, these usernames. I mean, I shouldn't be complaining with the username Swiss001, but that's at least easy to pronounce. He's got a YouTube channel, but this is his setup. I mean, we do gotta appreciate the A340 here. That's all right. Yeah, well, yeah, you know, there's a lot of contrast there in the setups. We have, for example, this one here, which actually isn't too bad. This Thrustmaster control here. What I don't like is that there's no throttle, right? You have to control throttle with this kind of little stick here. That sucks. Genuinely. Other than that, this looks kind of like a school computer, but that's all right. No, that's generally like a pretty all right setup. I mean, this is not the largest desk. Making the best out of it is important. Obviously, your computer specs are very important as well. I don't know about these here. Okay, here's another pretty respectable setup right here. I like that desk there. By the way, what has this YouTube channel become? I don't really know. I mean, he's making videos about desktops. I don't like this keyboard though. It seems a little too small for me. Even though I like having like a small keyboard between my flight controls, which by the way, here are the new Airbus Thrustmaster controls, which I think are pretty cool. But I'm not quite sure about the quality. This is pretty much a very cheap controls. So I'm not quite sure whether this is just gonna be plastic, right? But this looks cool, this throttle for sure. I genuinely wanna buy this now just to fly Boeing, to be honest. Jesus. All right, here we have the first dual screen setup for today with a respectable checklist here as well. That's good to see. Is that a PS4? I don't know. Why would you have a PS4 when you have like a proper computer? That I don't get. All right, here we have a pretty good, respectable Logitech Extreme controller on this plastic thing here. That's pretty cool. I mean, you know, if you don't have a lot of desk space, I used to have a really, really small desk. You can, just make the best out of it by just... Is that a Swiss001 movie for flight patch, by the way? This is really cool. Actually, this is not bad. I like the LED. That's really important. We have not actually mentioned the LED part. Tommy Rutai, go hard on it. First of all, we have books. That's very important to read. And then we have the computer itself. It's on the left here. Pretty good specs, I think. I can see RTX or GTX and Microsoft Flight Simulator. And an extra monitor that actually is for the map. That is actually a really, really good idea to have. I don't even have that myself. Good flight controls as well. The SciTech yoke. I mean, it's all right. It's workable. And cable management is like a 4 out of 10. But, you know, I shouldn't judge. I mean, you know, we don't want to talk about my desk looking like this. Pretty much, yeah, this is not good cable management on my side either. Diego, my setup. Are you playing with a laptop here, or is it like an extra computer? I mean, I shouldn't judge either. I was playing on a laptop for years and years and years on a MacBook. I even recorded videos on it. Actually, it worked pretty well, probably better than you might expect. So we don't. Is that War Thunder though? I think that's War Thunder. But pretty respectable setup. I mean, we have a joystick. There's been some submissions without any joysticks at all. So you know, that's all right. Here we have another laptop situation. Is that a dinner table? Yeah. I mean, at least we have a yoke system. That is really nice to see for sure. And as long as this laptop actually can run XPN 11, it's totally fine to go, you know? No worries about this setup. Looks fine to me. I mean, there's been worse today. This is a very clean setup for sure. We have a respectable wine glass here. Very well cleaned desk. Always appreciated. And we have, oh my God, look at how many taps these are. Jesus Christ. I mean, that probably means that this guy has a very powerful computer that you can play X-Plane on perfectly fine. Look how many, oh, software, Jesus Christ. I mean, yeah, pretty respectable computer then. Good microphone, I guess. I don't know what microphone that is. But where are the flight controls? That doesn't look like a good flight simulation setup, but you know, this is a setup you can work with, right? Oh, damn, all right. Here we now have a triple screen setup with this laptop here, which I hope is not running the X-Plane, right? I just hope, you know, running two monitors at the same time and X-Plane as well would probably be very challenging, but I think that's another computer down there. A lot of side tech yokes. I've not even realized how immensely popular these things are. I mean, I have one myself, so yeah. LED, that's also nice to see, and we have bass. We have a bass. Bass in the background, that's good to see as well. All right, that is actually a very good setup here now. Placement of the keyboard is a little bit on the... Just put your computer to the ground, dude. You have more space on your desk. But it is a nice looking computer, so, you know, there's two sides of it. Yeah, what would you do? I think it would put the computer down and have more space on the desk. The monitor's nice, actually, to see. Here's that Palma de America. Again, that airport with no Boeing 747 saying on it. And that's really nice. Good setup right there. My flight sim setup. All right, we have a throttle. We have X-Plane. Okay, just a screenshot right there. And, oh, that is very dusty flight control. Wait. Did he, like, build some pedals? With Lego and an extreme joystick? That is respectable now. Someone's really just, yeah. Yeah, these are the rudder pedals, dude. That's very creative though. I mean, as long as it works. Tyler Farpen, setup photos. And we have Rick Astley. Oh, but a nice, I like that. See, this is something I would never do myself, but I like to see this vertical screen setup, right? That's really nice and a good control as well. You know, that's really respectable. That's pretty much all you need for flying. Your fan is not straight, dude. Here we have someone doing two laptops. I mean, that's not too bad, but where's the controls, dude? We need a flight sim setup. Oh, and we have another one of those people that have the X52, just like I do. A very, very nice joystick, and this is not a paid ad or anything. But I would really appreciate it if Logitech actually sponsored me. Yeah. Okay, monitor. Good computer, apparently. I mean, it's running A320 X-Plane. So that's really good. No, not bad. Not bad at all. All right, here we have some of those weird people that play X-Plane with a PlayStation controller. How are you going to fly a plane with that, dude? And I tried it once and I'm never doing it again, for sure. Oh, wow. All right, finally a good setup right there. We have a honeycomb yoke here and the throttle quadrant of them. Also, this is unpaid. I just want to get this. Just send me this for free. Thank you so much. No, but we have the new throttle as well that honeycomb is making. Really, really nice, actually. This is also a very clean desk for, what is that? I don't know. Now this is actually pretty good now. We have a lot of LEDs here. Jesus Christ. And then we have a respectable cat and a laptop running prepared 3Ds. That's all right. So yeah, that's been today's video. And that was actually quite fun looking at your setups. I mean, there's a lot of them, but in general, a lot of setups as you guys are a lot better than just my joystick right here. I mean, and my very dusty keyboard is very disgusting. So yeah, guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. And I'll see you tomorrow. As always, good night. Now, thank you to all my members here on YouTube, like Mubarak, Block, Moritz, Deload, Toby Cook, of course, Great Grandpa John, Mark, Leo, Philip, No You, Larry, Finn M, Thomas, Riley Preston, Government Pasta, Will, Philip, Iskanvi, Kelamati, Airlines, Opalax, Cherry, and Kelly Chaos. Thank you so much.